nariyan pa rin ang banta ng COVID-19. Lalo't may mga nadidiscovering bagong variant ng coronavirus. Pero hindi na natin kakayanin ang isa pang lockdown. Wala na tayong gagawing lockdown.
During his first State of the Nation address, President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. vowed that his administration will no longer implement COVID-19 lockdowns as part of the government's overall pandemic response. Marcos says the government will focus instead on the administration of booster shots to protect the population, all while looking into implementing a new COVID-19 restrictions classification that will be more responsive to the current pandemic situation. Health Department OIC Undersecretary Maria Rosario Vergere says the DOH supports the administration's COVID strategy.
Everybody has to shift the mindset that we are all living with a virus, and therefore we need to shift also the value that we give to the number of cases versus the system's capacity of our healthcare. So with this kind of situation, we are one and of course supports the call of the president that there won't be any lockdowns anymore.
Also among the current administration's health plans, to lower the price of medicines and to build more health centers and hospitals around the country. This includes establishing specialty hospitals outside Metro Manila.
Napakinabangan natin ng gusto ang malalaking specialty hospital gaya ng Heart Center, Lung Center, Children's Hospital at National Kidney and Transplant Institute. Kaya maliwanag na hindi lang dapat dito sa National Capital Region kundi maging sa ibang parte ng bansa.
Along with these plans of the administration, Vergere says the DOH plans to further expand the public's access to medical care, especially in far-flung areas.
We're going to establish further our telemedicine services or our telehealth services so that we can continuously decongest our facilities and we can also reach those far-flung areas in the country. Aside from that, strengthening our facilities as what the President mentioned yesterday in Isona, that we will have these specialty care facilities in different regions of the country as well as our primary care facilities.
Medical experts meanwhile lauded the inclusion of a measure that seeks to establish a medical reserve corps in the administration's legislative agenda. Dr. Anna Ong Lim told ANC that the last 2 years of the pandemic have highlighted the country's urgent need for such an organization.
I think organizing this very big chunk of manpower that we have that may not have been mobilized efficiently is going to be a very good move in case we ever need it again, and also to get people involved in public service in an organized way.
The DOH also lauded the President's plans to establish the country's own National Disease Prevention and Control Center and a Virology Institute to respond to the country's health emergencies. But the Alliance of Health Workers is not satisfied with the President's SONA, which they say lacks specifics on how the government plans to address the concerns of medical workers.
Mas gusto sana ng mga health workers malinaw sa mismo sa bibig niya, masabi niya na, okay, mga health workers, don't worry, dahil kayo ang mga bayani sa panahon ng pandemya, i-release na natin ang mga benepisyon ito, yung inaantay niyong one COVID allowance kasama yung health emergency allowance as soon as possible.
In his speech, the President noted that the foundation of a strong health system is in the quality of its health professionals and that the government will exert efforts to improve the welfare of doctors, nurses, and frontliners. Mananatiling mababa ang bilang